Hi everyone, and welcome to the Ana Dialogue, the dialogue on analog music reproduction. What is this? Well, this is a stroboscopic disc. I'm sure a lot of you have seen this, and maybe you're wondering, what is this? How do you use it? Well, actually this, or the concept behind it, is rather important. Because in this video, in fact, we're going to discover how to check if your turntable is going at the correct speed. Let's take a look. Okay, so this is gonna be a very quick video because I'm not gonna tell you how to use this, or at least I will give you the main information, because I think there are other solutions now that work just as well or even better. So let's dive in and let's take a look what are our options in order to achieve a correct speed, because that's a paramount aspect. Apart from having a good turntable, cartridge, system, etc., all the different aspects we've covered in other videos, this is one of the main, most important aspects, because if the speed of the turntable is not precisely that of the required by the record, the standard record, as we all know, is 33 revolutions per minute and 1/3, and or 45 RPM for a single, or 78 for shellacs, etc. So if we do not have that exact speed, unfortunately, we're going to have distortion. We're going to have issues in the music reproduction, among all wow and flutter issues. So let's take a look on our options.
Okay, guys. So let's take a look on a few resources we can find online in order to achieve the correct measurement of the speed of our turntable. So let's start to take a look here at Vinyl Engine. Vinyl Engine is a fantastic and free use, free roaming, free database, free tools put together by the vinyl community. And here you can find a lot of manuals of information regarding everything that is hi-fi. I mean, tape decks, not only vinyl, but also other typologies of music reproduction gear, but mainly vinyl, obviously. So talking about strobe discs, here you have a variety of very interesting files, PDFs. You can in fact download the 60 hertz and 50 hertz version, different kinds of version for the various speeds. You also have to know what kind of frequency the electric current in your house is using. And mainly, we have two typologies, 50 hertz and the 60 hertz. This is a good idea to check this map of worldwide mains frequencies. In fact, I already downloaded a few things. Here you can see the main frequencies in the world. And as you can see, North America is mainly around the 60 hertz. In other places, we also have 50, but let's say this part of the world has 60 hertz, while the rest of Europe and Asia goes around 50 hertz. So you have to remember that in order to choose which typology. For example, here I downloaded the multi-speed with, see, it's clearly stated here, 50. If your electric current in your house, it goes on with a 50 hertz typology of frequency. In this case, see, we have 33, 45, 78, also 16. These are the various speeds you can check if you want to use a stroboscopic disc. If you do not, and I don't think that's necessary, because also, as I said, you're going to need a fluorescent light otherwise, you have excellent options within the application typology connected to your smartphone, if you have a smartphone. Otherwise, you can use the stroboscopic disc. For iPhones, I think this is probably the best, the RPM app, which appears to be very precise. I do not have an iPhone. I used to have it, but I don't have it anymore, so I don't know how good this is, but it's free, and according to what I have found online, this should be very good. Actually, this is probably even better than the one I found for Android, but let's take a look to that one as well. For Android, I found this also very nice and very simple application, which is called RPM Calculator, which again is free, and this is designed for Android phones. Obviously, the smartphones, as reported here, need a gyroscope or a gyrometer in order to measure that typology of information, which are the movement of the phone on the platter. But let's take a look better what we're talking about.
Okay, so let's try to understand how this works actually, and then see what kind of issues or solutions we can have. So this is, let's just say, a standard Technics turntable. The layout is very similar across various models. As you can see, maybe you've always wondered what is exactly this part. Well, actually, this part is dedicated to communicate us if the speed is correct or not, or if there are differences. In fact, if we turn on the turntable, here we have a special kind of light, a fluorescent light, because if you use different kinds of illuminations, it's not going to work. Plus, you also have to know the frequency, in Europe, we're mainly using 50 hertz, while instead in the United States, it's 60 hertz. And that frequency obviously is going to influence the correct reading of the stroboscopic aspects. So this is practically this. It's the same thing, just that you already have it incorporated here. So now, for example, this turntable is set at 33 RPM. So if we let it go ahead and play, as you can see, in the center, we have these two, it depends from where you're looking at it, two or three dots. If those dots are perfectly firm, stable, they're not moving, that means that in this case, the 33 and one-third RPM is correctly reproduced. It's perfect. Now, for example, I'm going to change to 45, and for a second, you're not going to see that. Did you see that? Because the motor adjusted. Now, this is an excellent turntable, and it adjusted in a microsecond. In other cases, especially if you're using a belt drive, it'll take a little more. So the same if we go on 78. Now, see, in that case, it took a little more. Plus, let's go back to 33. Our standard speed. In order to show you what I'm talking about now, start touching this, which regulates the pitch, which means I would increase or decrease the turntable speed. So now it's set to reset, so it practically cancels any type of adjustment. Now I'm going to remove this, and I'm going to show you what's going to happen over here. Okay, so now I'm going to change the pitch and see what happens. I'm going to slightly increase it, and as you can see, the dots start to drift towards right, which means that the speed is not correct anymore and it's a little higher. If I instead bring down the pitch adjustment, you'll see that the drifting of those dots, obtained thanks to the fluorescent light, shows that now this time they're going towards left, and that will increase the more I increase also the pitch. As you can see, now we have a completely incorrect speed if we're trying to put 33 RPM. Now I'm going to press the reset button, and all of a sudden everything is going to turn back perfect as it's supposed to go, the correct speed. Tick, you see that? That was very quick. So practically, that's what this is already set, because the layout of this turntable was used mainly for DJs, so that's why it was important to know the pitch, to know the speed, because DJs obviously change speed in order to obtain some effects. This is an audiophile grade turntable, so that's completely different now, but these things remain because it's a classic design of Technics, and that's basically what we're trying to do. So as I said, this part, if you have it on your turntable, you're set. If you have the fluorescent light, you're set. You don't care about anything else. But in a lot of turntables, you don't have that. So you would need something like this, usually. And unfortunately, you're going to need a fluorescent light. You're going to have to print it out, and I'll show you where and how to do that. But I think we also have other options. Well, let's try and see what we can do. Okay, so as we briefly saw before, we're going to use this application called RPM Calculator. This is for an Android phone. If you have an iPhone, use the other program I indicated before. Obviously, you need a decent quality phone, a smartphone. If it's Samsung, if it's other Android typologies, or an iPhone, there's no problem. Just don't go up to the bottom line, because obviously the gyroscope and the other elements, electronic elements, need to be of a certain quality in order to be precise, I think, at least. So let's try to see what's gonna happen. I'm gonna set it here. I'm gonna reset it, touching it. See, our little burger has to be zero. Everything has to be completely zero in order to start. And as we said before, we already know that the speed is precise thanks to the elements of the Technics turntable. So this is gonna demonstrate how precise is this typology of phone, and how precise it also the generations of phones that we have now, because there are lots of YouTube videos with old phones which aren't that precise, I think. But now we're at a decent point, and I think the applications and the electronics of the phones are rather precise, as in this case. But let's see for ourselves. Let's start with 33 RPM. As you can see, at this speed, 33.3 is practically obtained in a precise way. We have a slight change in velocity, but that's rather normal. I mean, it depends. I mean, I did this test a lot of times. Sometimes it stays still, sometimes it changes a little bit, but as you can see, 33.3. Let's go up to 45. And also in this case, we have a pretty stable indication of 45 RPM. As you can see, a slight fluctuation, which it may be also present. I'm not saying that it's the phone or the app, but it could be that the turntable does have a very, very slight variation. So let's go all the way up to 78. Let's see what happens. Okay, well, also at this speed, I can see that there is a little stronger fluctuation, but as you can see, it's always a 0.1 error, mistake. So we are absolutely around 78, which, as you can see, goes 77.9 or 78. So now our test is done. Well, okay, guys, I hope this was helpful. I think these apps are rather reliable. The speed is correct, as indicated and confirmed by the Technics table, and vice versa from the app. So I think even if you're going to buy a used turntable and you're not sure of the condition, just drop your phone with that app on top and see if the speed is correct. That's a good idea. And test it to the higher speed as well, because that's where it gets a little more difficult, 45 or even 78, if the turntable is capable of doing that. Well, okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Hope to see you soon. Bye.